good looking thing, isn't it?
Oh, it's a cracker.
Classic shape, like French. I think it's 50s, but it looks a little bit early. It looks like a 30s, 40s.
Yeah, it's got a deco look to it.
It has, hasn't it? I love it. It's got its nice old French sign, sticking a 10 franc coin. Got the little pulley thing at the side to release all the balls.
Wow.
It's all working, yeah, nice.
One of the first official patents for table football was taken out in 1921 by Tottenham Hotspur fan Harold Searles Thornton. He came up with the idea on the way home from a match at White Hart Lane. But it was across the channel in football-crazed France where the game really took off. Numerous French makers sprang up, producing tables from high-quality material, and by the 1960s, the game had become an essential part of French café culture.
But you've noticed the woodworm.
It's probably the most woodworm-ridden piece of furniture I've ever seen you buy.
Because you reckon it's beach? It looks like beach.
Well, it is, yeah. And I'm guessing, just by the state of it, I mean, especially if you're saying it's 50s, this has obviously lived outside, hasn't it?
Yeah, hasn't it?
It's spent a lot of time being weathered, because woodworm does not like beach. The only way it would eat it is if it was soft. And I'm guessing if it's been soaking wet, it softened the beach and the worms got in.
Mm.
The amount of time it's going to take to fill each of these tiny little holes, sand them down and polish it to look lovely again.
Another thing that's all gone is all the veneer's blown on the side.
Well, every panel, isn't it?
Look at
it. Well, do you know, I can get thin ply with really nice veneer on.
Yeah, perfect. But do you know a man who can make these little players look?
Missing some of your squad. I'm sure we can get them fixed for you.
Yeah.
That shouldn't be too
difficult. Right, perfect. And then what about this warpy bass?
It needs a new one, doesn't it?
Yeah.
You can't play on that.
Yeah, when we get it in a nice green.
I guess you didn't pay much money for this, then.
Well, I'm not going to tell you how much it was, but if it is what I think it is, then, they're into, like, mid-thousands.
Blimey.
So it's a serious thing. So I'll leave that with you.
Thanks very much.
All right, give us a bell.
Don't come back in a hurry. This will take a while.
All right, cheers.
Alex begins by soaking the first pieces of timber in a treatment to kill off any active woodworm. Then the strip-down of the table can begin.
This is one of those jobs where you realise you cannot make an omelette without cracking eggs. And I'm going to have to make this table look a whole lot worse than it does now before I can even begin to make it look any better. Well, it's really not giving us much of a fight. It's just crumbling apart.
For Alex to preserve the authenticity of the table, at least some of the framework needs to be in good condition.
We may have actually found some panels that can be saved. Now I'm looking at this, there isn't really much woodworm actually inside the unit. We've got a few holes scattered around, but not nearly as bad as it was on the outside.
The final things to come off are the warped and peeling plywood panels, which all need replacing.
I mean, this at the moment is just one of those jobs where there's no pretty way of demolishing it, really. Look at the state of my workshop.
Meanwhile, Rob has travelled across the channel to Lille in northern France. He's visiting Stella Loisir, a firm that's been making table footballs since 1928. As well as the workshops, the company has a large collection of vintage tables. Rob is meeting manager Damien Convert, who knows all about them. He wants to discover more about his table's history, which could increase its value.
So, Damien, this is great. We're walking through the factory and showing me just amazing pieces, but what I want to do is show you the pictures of my table, see if you recognise anything yourself there.
I do recognise it. It's a really particular shape with the V shape of the feet, yeah. It's a brand final. It's a wonderful table, manufactured in France.
Yeah, because I was looking at that thinking, is this like a deco? Is this like a 20s? But this is a lighter table.
Yeah, probably a bit older, like the 50s, 60s. We have the same one. I can show you the
really?
Yeah.
Okay, this is amazing.
Final football tables were built in the east of France, an area well known for table football manufacturing. They were produced throughout the 1940s and 1950s and were built using high-quality materials such as solid beechwood and chrome, making them sought after by aficionados of the game.
And that's the table.
This is so interesting for me because what I'm looking at home is so gone and worn. But, I mean, it is incredible. The four ashtrays. I mean, that's quite a fancy ashtray. It sets the scene, doesn't it? You think of people now playing.
You can imagine the atmosphere.
Yeah, serious. And this pitch.
It's
material.
A specific material with a lot of grip.
As a guide, right. How do you value something like?
I would say around 3,000 euros.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's great, because that really helps me. And that's the famous
cogball. It's made to have a lot of control and make the pass and then make the shoot. And goal.
Yes, that's great. Brilliant.
Today, dealer Rob Cain is back in Colwyn Bay, ready to collect his dilapidated 1950s football table that Alex has been trying to get back to match fitness. He's hoping for a good result.
Now, to say this table had some issues is an understatement. It ended up in absolute bits. And there were times myself where I thought, I hope I can get this back together. But I hope he's happy with the final result. Rob.
Alex, how you doing?
Good to see you again. Your table.
Looks like a table.
It's in one piece.
It's like the coolest thing I've had this year, so.
Oh, no pressure then.
Okay, let's have a look.
Look.
Yeah. Oh, it's nice. I absolutely love it.
Yeah, I mean, obviously the players, we've kept them looking original. The metalwork's just had a little bit of wire wool to clean it up. But really, yeah. It's about knocking it apart and gluing it back together. And then Ted has made the replacement man for us.
I can't tell.
It's this one. Little chap here.
Is it? Mm. It's amazing. How good's that?
Unbelievable, isn't it?
That's a skill.
When it arrived, this table hadn't been playable for years. The pitch was warped, a player was missing, and the whole thing was riddled with woodworm. Alex has laid a new vinyl-covered pitch and replaced all of the damaged wooden parts. Metal worker Ted's new cast aluminium player has been painted to ensure a perfect match with the rest of the squad.
It's incredible. It's really cool. Does it work?
Of course it works.
Right, let's have a go.
Oh, no spinning. Oh, it's safe. Look
at my defending.
Oh,
there we go.
Well done.
I've won at something. Great, I love it. It's so good, iconic piece. It's really nice. Everybody's going to love it. Although it is missing one item.
I've missed an item.
Well, these ashtrays, that's the original ashtray. The guy had it in his collection. If we can bob one on the corner, it can have some bowl sweets, you know, it can have a bit of cash.
I mean, what did it cost you? Was it under a grand?
Yeah, about 950 quid by the time it got here. And the guy I went to see in France, he's knocking them out between 3,000 and 5,000 euros.
Oh, wow.
So, I mean, I don't know what the value is, but you've done such a good job. The biggest thing I'm impressed about is how he's sort of preserved the feel of the table from the 50s. It's everything I love. Collectors love it, it's iconic. You know, it's fashionable, it's a stylish piece, social history, it's old, it's restored. Yeah, this is a great day.
Now, part of the appeal of one of these tables is basically it tells that story, it's got that romance about it, the smoky Parisian bars and cafes. We had to keep that character in the table at the same time, make it usable, playable, durable, so it can fit into a more contemporary surroundings and whoever buys it can make the most of it.